एनिमल फॉर्म एंड फंक्शन टू टुडे लेक्चर 9। स्टूडेंट्स टुडे वी विल डिस्कस टेम्परेचर एंड बॉडी फ्लूइड रेगुलेशन। इन विच टेम्परेचर रेगुलेशन यू कैन सी इन द डायग्राम। बॉडी फ्लूइड रेगुलेशन इन दिस डायग्राम। Temperature regulation fishes. As fishes live in the aquatic environment and temperature remain near to constant in the aquatic environment, so they have to live in almost same environment, either in the cold water or either in the warm water. The temperature of the surrounding water determines the body temperature of most fishes. Fishes that live in extremely cold water have the antifreeze material in the blood. Basically blood or enzymes need special or specific temperature for their activity. So just to protect the enzymes, the fishes maintain antifreeze agent in their blood. They may be polyalcohols, sorbitol, glycerol, water soluble peptides or glycoproteins that lower the temperature, lower the freezing point of the blood. Then they also have the proteins, heat shock proteins that protect the enzymes, and protein sugar compounds that stunt the growth of ice crystals that begin to form. Basically protein sugar compounds make the fluid super saturated, and in super saturated solution ice crystal will be hard to form. These adaptations enable the fishes to stay flexible, swim freely, super cooled state, and at a temperature below the normal freezing temperature of a solution. The most active fishes maintain a core temperature above the temperature of the water, and bluefin tuna and the great white shark have major blood vessels just under the trunk. Branches deliver to the deeper, powerful red swimming muscles. Here you can see in the diagram, this diagram, just see, here is a trunk. In the A diagram, bluefin tuna, the body of the tuna is warmer inside. The core temperature or the core body temperature is very high, that is 29 to 31 degrees, but when you go to the peripheral side or area just near the surface of the water, that will have the low temperature, that is 25 23 and then 21. And in the B diagram you can say the great white shark have the blood vessels. Red blood vessels are arteries and blue blood vessels are the veins. When blood goes to the body surface or the towards the skin, then through the artery it will have the warmer blood, and the blood coming from the surface through the vein have the colder blood. So before the colder blood enter into the center of the fish or the core surface in the fish core area, then this warmer blood will transfer the heat to the colder blood in the vein. It means that now arteries going toward the surface have the lower temperature, and the veins coming to the center of the fish have the high temperature, that is rate admirable or counter current exchange. Rate admirable are smaller vessels arranged in counter current exchange mechanisms. Heat generated by red blood vessels not lost because transferred in the rate admirables from venous blood passing outward to colder arterial blood passing inward from the body surface. This arrangement of vessel enhance activating by the swimming muscles. When blood goes to the swimming muscles, then muscles swim and produce the heat. So blood will have the more heat when it pass to the swimming muscles. Several degree warmer than the tissue near the surface of the fish, as I have discussed earlier. Again the diagram, same. Temperature regulation in amphibians and reptiles. Amphibians and reptiles live in the aquatic environment as well as in terrestrial environment. And mostly reptiles live in the terrestrial environment. And amphibians are the mediocre. Sometime in the fish like aquatic environment and sometime in the terrestrial environment. So air medium face marked temperature variations on the daily basis, on the seasonal basis. It means ke on the early morning temperature will be low, on the day, mid of the day temperature will be high, and then again at the night temperature will be low. Seasonal again, summer have the high temperature, winter have the low temperature. Ectotherms. Amphibians and reptiles are basically the ectotherms, and they depend upon the environmental temperature. Derive heat from their environment, and body temperature varies with external temperature. So when external temperature is high, they will keep their body temperature high. When external is low, then they will keep their temperature low. Amphibian thermoregulation. How amphibians maintain their temperature balance? Difficulty in controlling body heat as they produce little heat metabolically. Their metabolic rate is very low. Then rapidly lost most of its body surface. They don't have the insulating layers. And because of no feathers, no hairs, no fat in the body, they cannot sustain the heat inside, and heat will be lost rapidly in the environment. So they have some behavioral adaptations. Behavioral adaptations enables maintain their body temperature, as sometime they go into the sun for sun basking, or sometime they go near the water for moisture, for low temperature. Homeostatic range most of the time. Exchange oxygen and carbon dioxide across their skin surface. Because they exchange their gases across the skin surface, then moisture will be lost. As oxygen takes place, gaseous exchange takes place across the moist surface. So they have to keep their surface moist, and when moist, then water evaporation will lower the temperature also. Moisture layer act as a natural evaporative cooling system, and evaporation limits the habitats. It means ke they cannot leave the water area. They have to live near the water area. They cannot live in the deserts. Activities of amphibians to warm moist area. Here you can see a burrowing amphibian in the clay. The frog is able to insulate itself from temperature changes. So just burrow in the soil and enjoy the temperature change free environment. Bullfrog can vary the amounts of mucus secretes from their body surface and helps regulate evaporative cooling. So bullfrog will cover their bodies by the mucus, and this will maintain the body and will regulate the evaporating cooling, maintain body temperature. Thermoregulation in reptiles. Reptiles have the dry skin, having the scales, reduce the loss of heat through the evaporative cooling. Expandable rib cage is there, so they expand their rib cage, insert more oxygen, more air inside, allows for more powerful, efficient ventilation. Reptiles are almost completely ectothermic, having the low metabolic rate just like the amphibians, and behavioral adaptations just like amphibians. Thermoregulation in this diagram. In this, a reptile is lying on the substrate, getting radiation from the sun and getting heat from the substrate where it lies, then dissipating its heat into the air through the convection and dissipating heat through the evaporative loss. The arrowhead going toward the reptile showing heat gain, and the arrow going away from the reptile is dissipating heat. Modes of thermoregulation is the changing in the body color to absorb more heat. When an animal is in darker color, it will absorb more heat. When an animal is a lighter color, then it will dissipate more heat. It cannot absorb more heat. Here you can see the darker lizard and the greenish lizard. Other strategies are also there. Diving reptiles, they dive in the water. Sea turtles, sea snakes are the examples. Circulatory shunts into the center of the body increase heat production by hormones thyroxine and epinephrine. Then they also start salivation, produce the saliva, urinate on their legs just for the evaporative cooling. Moisten their eyes, it will evaporate and cooling effect, panting just like the dog. Temperature regulation in birds and mammals. Birds and mammals are the most active and behaviorally complex vertebrates, live in all habitats over the earth because they are homeothermic and they are endothermic. They maintain their body temperature between 35 and 42 degrees by metabolic heat. They will maintain their body temperature, so that's why they are endotherms. And thermoregulation in birds, they prevent excessive warming by cooling method because they don't have the sweat glands. Birds also start panting. Evaporative cooling will take place through the tongue. Then they have the gular flutter. Gular flutter are present in their neck region. Highly vascularized gular pouch in their throat that can flutter. Increase evaporation from the respiratory system. Here you can see in the diagram. In this diagram, in the yellow color. This is a gular flutter. When air will pass through this gular flutter, then there will be evaporative cooling. Some birds possess mechanisms for preventing heat loss that have the feeders, especially down feeders. Down feeders are very small feeders that cover the newborn chick. When you observe the chick, they don't have the very beautiful feeders, but they have the small feeders. Just remind that you have the yellow colored chicks in your childhood. So that chick was covered with the down feeders. Or trap a layer of air next to the body and reduce the heat loss. That is just like your sweater. When you wear a sweater in the winter, then that sweater will prevent the heat loss from your body because there is no air passageway. Aquatic species lose heat from their legs and feet, and they retain their body temperature through the diving, and also they have the variety marbles. Peripheral countercurrent heat exchange vessels in their legs to reduce heat loss. Here is a retimarable. You can see retimarables, just arteries and veins, just to discuss in the shocks, just like this. That vein has now colder and artery have the warmer. But when it will go to the periphery in the claws area, then a heat exchange will take place before entering that claw, and heat will go to the vein from the artery. As heat always move from higher temperature area to the lower temperature area. Here you can see in the diagram that 0 to 5 degree in the claw, then in the legs 8 degree, 15 and then 32. Temperature regulation in mammals. That animals live in the cold area or in the hot area. In the cold area have the retimarbles, in the legs, in the tails, in the ears, in the nose. They also have some mechanisms for thermoregulation. Animals in the cold area have special arrangements, and animals in the hot climates also have longer ears to get rid of excess body heat. This animal have the longer ears, and they will dissipate the heat from these blood vessels to the environment. Blubber. Blubber is an insulating fat under the skin, maintain body temperature in marine mammals 36 to 38 degree in the tail flippers, and have no blubber. Countercurrent system of arteries and veins minimize heat loss. Birds and mammals also use behavioral mechanisms like ectotherm. They use sun basking, hoodling from the cluster. They share burrows, migration to warm climates, and hibernation in the winter. Birds are migratory animals. You well known. Thanks.